Hey everyone, and welcome back to the show. Lovely weather out here in Pune city. It's super pleasant, it's drizzling, and it's a little breezy. So if you guys aren't out there going for treks or bike rides or long drives, I don't know what the fuck you're doing. Now, before I tell you about my extremely entertaining and super awesome guest, please show some love to the channel. Share the video, like the video, do comment below, and don't forget to subscribe and do press the bell icon. My guest today is a blogger, a lifestyle blogger, if you will. She talks about food. She shares all her experiences from the cafes, restaurants, and hangout places. She herself has gone through an amazing transformation. So she talks about fitness. She talks about diet. She also shares her opinion on various social issues. Her Instagram account is one of the most entertaining accounts I've ever gone through. I love her posts. I've shared her details down below. If you guys aren't following her, you guys are missing out. We had a fantastic conversation where she shared her journey from being a helpless Instagram addict to this person who has found balance in life. She is one hell of a company. I thoroughly enjoyed my conversation with her, and I hope you guys enjoy the conversation as well. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome my guest, the beautiful, the entertaining Naman Vijay Sharma. Hey Naman, welcome to the show.
Hi.
Good to have you over here.
Awesome to
have you. I'm glad I came across your Instagram account. I love your posts. I enjoy them. I really do. And the reason why is that, you know, there's a lot of positivity. First thing, I don't hunt for that. I'm not that positive.
Yeah.
But, you know, but whatever comes. So the thing is that whenever you post, it's, of course, it's glamorous and a bit dramatic as well sometimes. Yeah.
Yeah, very dramatic.
So, but the thing is that it's genuine.
Yeah.
It's genuine, and, you know, people don't like getting preached.
They don't.
Yeah.
Oh my God.
They don't like getting preached at when people are talking like, you know, okay, do this. Even at the age of, let's say, 19, 20, people are posting and, you know, claiming that do fucking do this and you will get such results and all. I like it because you're doing your thing and you're telling and sharing that, okay, I do this.
Yeah.
You're not telling people to follow or anything or something like that. So tell me, how does it, you know, how does it work for you?
Okay, so Instagram, especially Instagram, specifically, happened to me at the time it was launched, actually. So
that will be when?
I think it was 2009. When it got launched, I think it was 2007, 8. Okay, so when I say launched, I mean like when it became a thing.
Right, it became a thing.
It became a thing. Right. So, and around the time, so I was on it immediately. So I had an account over it. Then I started an account back then, and it was, I'll be honest, it wasn't as genuine as it might look like.
Everyone starts, right?
Yeah. Everybody, like, you just have to start somewhere. And
right.
It was crazy. It was random and really stupid.
Tell me about that. I need to know how stupid. What did you
like,
do?
You know, it was things like...
And how old were you when you started Instagram? 20?
Yeah, I think so.
Okay.
Yeah.
Before that, you were Facebooking, right?
Yeah. And my Facebook was equally stupid.
Right.
Okay. So, like, I used to wish celebrities happy birthday.
Like, personally?
Like, no, I what I would do is I would download photos from the internet. Mm-hmm. Like, I would download, like, their best photos.
Right.
And I would, like, go on looking for quotes that they made.
Right.
And because quotes are, like, super important to me.
Right.
So I would, like, really, really, you know, search for the perfect quote. And then I would post that picture with the quote and wish them happy birthday.
Another thing that I really like about, sorry to cut you off in the middle. I really like about your account is that you often write poems or quotes, right?
Yeah.
And then the good part is that you always credit the writer, right?
Yeah.
I don't see that pretty often. Like, you know, people write good stuff and then they pretend as if, okay, mere words hai, maine gyan diya hai. So, yeah.
No, initially I would even actually tag the writer, but a couple of times I think that didn't go down really well with a couple of people where...
Did you get a backlash?
They didn't say anything to me, and they were really civil about it also, but I think they felt that I should have probably told them or taken permission for it or whatever.
Right.
And my assumption of it is you have 100k, 200k going on your account. I'm sure you're looking for visibility. Like, that is a stereotype maybe in my head. So that didn't go down well. So I was like, okay. Then I actually started messaging people, and I would never get responses from them. And then like that quote really went like with my photo, and I was like, I want to use it. Let me use it. And I would not get responses. And then I just started like doing this thing where I was like, listen, I'll just hashtag it or whatever. And if somebody tells me not to do it, then I just take it down.
Right.
Whatever. So initially all of that, so coming back to that, so I was equally crazy on Facebook and it was stupid, and then Instagram happened. I think what really changed for me, why I'm, okay, so that account got taken down by Instagram, by the way.
What did you do?
I'll tell you what happened 2 years ago. And I
because they have this, you know, if you are against that certain algorithm, then only. Or you strike the warning signs.
Yes, exactly.
What did, that's why I'm interested.
I'm
what did you
what,
do?
What did I do? I was an Instagrammer of the highest order. I would post every hour or 2 hours every day. That is
so you were addicted, basically.
Yeah, I was proper addicted.
Right.
And it was, and I was also addicted because I had a lot of followers on that account.
Right.
I had 12,000 followers on that account when it went down.
Right.
So there was a lot of engagement. Honestly, I'm more engaging on this account. There's not a lot of engagement on that one, but it was a lot of like there was proper fanship built, you know, and I think that really got to my head, I'll be honest.
Yeah.
Because then I was constantly posting and it became like a thing, and then, you know, I was like, people know me, I'm the shiz, and all of that was going on,
yeah.
You know, especially teenager like behavior I was going through. And then I think it was my birthday, and my birthday is a major event, so I had like a ton of photos, and so I had this shit and I was like, oh my god, these are a lot of pictures. I have to post all of this on Instagram. And I was posting.
Hmm.
And I was posting those photos every half an hour, 15, 20 minutes I was posting. So I had like 200 photos to post or something like that in my head.
Hmm.
And I went so crazy. I think Instagram detected it as spam. That's what happened. Because
okay.
I contacted them and everything. I didn't get... See, all the replies that I got from them were automated. So...
Hmm.
It's basically a robot and you can't really actually talk
right.
to a person. But then I went and I researched about it. So there are things that you...
So there are no warnings for that? They just take you down?
Yeah, they just took it down. They just took it down and
okay.
I kept on mailing them for, I think, 6-7 months before I created this account,
right.
Naman Vijay Sharma. That was Naman V. Sharma.
Hmm.
And before this... You know, now that I look
What
back,
if it had become an important source of your income at that time?
Exactly. And
so they still take you down, right? They don't care? Oh, okay.
And the reasons being spam, like, you know, if they detected that, even if you follow a lot of people at one go,
right.
This happened to a friend of mine.
Yeah.
And because my friends didn't believe me, they thought that somebody probably reported it.
Okay.
And frankly, it's possible. If you really think about
haters.
It. With 12,000 followers, this has got to be one person who hates the love. Like,
but I don't think it requires... Like one person.
No.
Yeah, exactly. That's what I said.
So either they were 12,000 followers or they were 11,500 haters.
Exactly.
I don't like
that's
this girl. What does she think? No, I'm not saying that.
But they also review like what you're actually posting. Like,
yeah.
I know. That's what I exactly my point. That it's
cool.
Not like, you know, they're going to report like a nude image and Instagram is just going to be. So there was this one instance when there was this woman, I think somewhere in Alaska or somewhere.
Mm-hmm.
She put up a cake. Picture of her birthday cake, and it had this cherry or something. It was a skin like the color of the cake was skin like, and it had a cherry on it or something. And Instagram detected it as a poop picture.
I was guessing.
Yes, and they just took it down. They took her account down for that, and it's crazy. Like, you know, these regulations. So one of the major reasons why I didn't make another account for 6-7 months is like, and plus I had a lot of memories on that account. I had a boyfriend. Who passed away in 2016, I think.
Sucks,
yeah, love of my life and all that, the whole shebang. So, and every, like, you know, you have so many phones going on with you. Like, you probably don't have backup of every single phone, but Instagram was my backup.
Right.
And it all just went away. And I even sent them like this big essay. It was so dramatic. Oh my God, now that I think of it, it was a big essay about... My late boyfriend, and I told them, you know, like, I lost him and stuff, and your application is the only place where I have like a ton of pictures
right.
of him. Please give it back to me. I have his comments in there, and I love it.
So I'll tell you something. I had a friend. So I don't know whether you remember, but this poker thing was really huge on Facebook at one point.
Yes,
poker.
Yeah.
Zynga or Zynga, something like that. Yeah, that was really huge. I was in college at that point in time, right?
Mm-hmm.
So, a friend of mine, so he was really into poker, right?
Yeah.
He loved poker and he had earned. So, you had chips, right? So, you had so many K chips or M chips. I don't know how it worked at that time.
Yeah.
So, I think they took all his chips away or they did something that he couldn't play anymore Facebook did that. Facebook did that. That reminded me because you said that you had sent them an essay, right? So he also said, and he said that, listen, if you don't give my chips back, I'll commit suicide. That's what he said that. And he was laughing next day in the college. Yeah, he was like, listen, did they? I was like, no, man, they don't care.
Dude, I actually contacted a reporter from New York or something like that because she wrote an article about Instagram, like bashing them for taking an account down of this person. And Instagram gave that person the account back.
Right.
So I messaged her. I said, can you do that for me? And everything. And she was like, so I was very desperate.
So you were growing. 12K is a very good number.
Yeah.
But I've seen people who are doing, you know, you've seen people who are doing like massively.
Yes.
They've got like 100K and I don't even know them.
It's crazy.
Best part is you don't even know them.
You forgot the M's.
Like, we aren't even talking about the M's.
There are M's as well?
So I'm sure.
Yeah.
Sure.
No,
it's just that when you see
the M's, you know, I think.
I don't think.
No?
Or maybe I'm just not that involved. But
no,
I just.
Yeah, maybe, yeah.
So sometimes you even know the K's, right? And sometimes you don't even know the M's. That's me. Mere saath aisa hota hai.
Okay.
So I forgot what I was saying.
The people who matter.
Yeah, fuck it. Let's just, yeah, carry on. That was that for you. Someone interrupted and, you know, yeah.
So sorry.
Anyway, yeah.
So, yeah, point being that you were growing.
Listen, I've lost track now. It's
really?
Yeah,
okay.
Yeah.
So, point being that it took a while for my friends to go, like, listen, get back. Everybody starts messaging my best friends, my boyfriend, and like, she get her back,
right.
And everything. So, it was crazy. And then, eventually, I'm an Instagram addict.
So,
I'm like, dude, I'm not an Instagram addict as much as I am.
I'm sure you're improving right now. No, I don't think whether improving is the right term, but
improving as
getting
I
over it.
Changed so much.
You have
Instagram. It is unreal, and a lot of it is because of this account. Because ever since I came on this one, I don't know. It was a sort of. In any case, in your head, it's like a fresh start,
right?
So you want to do things right.
Mm.
If, like automatically, pehla first step to wahi pe ho jata, you're like, no, I want to keep this clean as much as possible.
Mm.
And then when I came, I saw what had changed in those 6 months, okay,
right.
On Instagram. So stories had become a thing. When I left, stories weren't that huge, you know. Now people put in more effort in the story than they do on the post.
Right.
You know, they're like, they have proper apps, like with fonts and everything.
Mm-hmm.
They will do proper stories, they will put in. So stories had become a thing, and you know, influencer had become a thing.
Yeah.
And so much of this, by the way, one of the biggest changes on Instagram has been, for me personally, is people have gone from concentrating on the post to concentrating on the feed. So now people are more concentrating on what the
feed. Please explain feed.
So basically, you know, a post is
the whole grid. How?
Yeah, you know, like color coordination.
Yeah.
And there are patterns that you
so
see.
There are I've seen videos where experts are, because we started this thing, so we want to get into social media as well.
Mm-hmm.
So we were watching videos, right? So they tell you that, okay, this is how your grid should look like.
Mm-hmm.
So for a business, I think it makes sense.
It does.
But
make
it's
sense.
Like, it has become a rat race now.
Yeah.
So everyone wants to do that.
So everyone is interested in aesthetic things.
Right.
It's
right.
Crazy. And I'll be honest, it does help. I have seen accounts that have like that kind of grid business going on, like crazy followers.
Yeah.
Because
it has no content, huh? Like it's all stupid stuff.
It's good photography.
It's just good photography.
It
is, exactly. So again, I'll give it to them where they need it, but it's just for me, I came back to a world of Instagram that I didn't relate to anymore. Like,
right.
I left doing completely random whatever I felt like. I'll be honest, the amount of genuinity that I hold this account with is great. I like it. I like that for myself, for my life. But I am not I am not impulsive anymore.
Okay.
You know, on my previous account, I could do anything. I would post like random quotation photos and stuff like that. Now I know that I can't fuck with my feed.
And another, you have to answer this really honestly.
Yeah.
So when you posted, at that time, when you were, you know, an addict.
Hmm.
So at that time, when you posted, how many likes before you were like, okay, now I can, you know, chill?
400.
For me, it's
for
like, dude.
Selfies, I guess. For selfies and stuff like, because,
so, I mean, of course you want more, but once it hits a mark, so it was 400. Once it hits 400, you're like, now I can talk to friends, now I can breathe and whatever.
That was crazy. No, but I'll tell you, see, recently I don't know if you've seen it, on my page, I did a post about, like, it was a before and after.
Yeah, the transformation.
Yeah, exactly.
I saw that, yeah.
I posted it because I really, really wanted to talk about something that I've been accused of. Like, you know, there are things that I've been accused of as in the fitness world. So I wanted to talk about something, and I did it because I wanted to put myself out there. Like, listen, I see y'all, I know what y'all are going through, and I want this to be my opinion of it.
Hmm.
I was not aiming at likes. That post got like 800 likes. It's my highest till date. I've never got 800 likes on this account. And I was like, what? And it had like 79 saves and everything. I was like, holy shit, I'm an influencer. I'm like, I'm here. And but let's be really honest. I'm just so glad people related to it. I'm so at the mark. Like, the kind of what makes me happy is not likes anymore. What makes me happy is when people link me my photo and they'd be like, you know, this made me happy, or this made me, you know, think about something.
Right.
This is what works for me now. And that's the biggest change, I think.
Because I've also seen that, you know, this happens to women. Of course, it happens to girls mostly.
Yeah.
So they post something and there are sleazy bastards out there. They write shit, right? See, I you see the reaction, right? So they talk stuff, they post stuff. They are jerks. Yeah, I know that. I'm not talking about them. I'm talking about the person who has who celebrates 2 million or, you know, 1 million. You know, they celebrate. They have this thing, right? They either put take a balloon or something, or they do different stuff, right? They're celebrating. 1 out of 2 million, let's say 1.5 million must be those assholes who are writing this stuff. So I don't know. I mean, it's really hard to find people who actually come, read your captions, read your post, relate to it, and then comment.
Exactly.
I think that those are the things one is really looking for, right?
No, this happens.
That surpasses your red.
Perfect.
Hmm.
Exactly. Spot on. Because see, and that's what happens on Instagram a lot for me, especially because of my captions.
Right.
So now, I linked Facebook and Instagram, right? So I posted the same picture on Facebook.
Right. Yeah.
The first two comments were awful.
Okay.
Someone said hot, someone said what a body or something like that.
You even find hot a bit?
I don't like that.
Anymore, or were you?
No, hot is something ever since I was a child.
So it's a personal thing, because I mean, if you are people, they don't know you. Yeah, I see where you're coming from.
No, I get it.
You don't like strangers commenting. Of course, you wouldn't if a stranger comes and says
hot.
That's
what I'm telling you, Abhi. If someone said hot on a selfie, if someone said hot even on a like a portrait, anything, I'm okay. I don't delete those comments. But that picture or that particular caption or whatever didn't deserve that comment. Not something when somebody's talking about
the
joke.
Then those are just men who just type.
Yeah, it's
female.
Just,
okay.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah.
It's okay, but it's Instagram.
Yeah. So how did it turn to food? Now your thing, right? That's
what
I really want to know.
Oh my God, yes. Oh,
how did you end up, you know, taking pictures of food? Because that's your thing now. You just know the city. Even beyond, you've crossed Pune, now you go to Bangalore
for food.
Yeah. So tell me. Yeah.
So I'm so glad we spoke about Instagram accounts first, because this is something that was very relevant on my previous account. So there were more pictures of food than there were of me.
Okay.
And that was really screwing with my growth, I'll be honest. So I was stuck at 11.9 for 6-7 months. And and that was screwing with my head. Like, why are people not following me? And I was getting a lot of unfollows. Okay, do you know there's an app for unfollowers?
No,
yeah,
no.
It tells you who will unfollow
you.
Yeah. Oh, tell me about it. Listen, we are also doing Instagram. Should we need to know this?
It's pretty epic, huh?
So they follow you and then they unfollow you.
No, you get an app that tracks who is unfollowing you.
Yeah.
So it gives you a notification and sends
what
this
the
person.
What the fuck? So you were stressed out, woman. You were worried about people who were unfollowing
you. Imagine.
Okay,
imagine.
So it makes a difference. You need to know why people
and
follow
why
you.
And why also? Also because
you.
When you post something and then immediately after that post, if somebody is unfollowing you, you want to know what you're doing wrong. You know? What
was that the real reason though?
For
you.
No, I wanted to know how many followers I'm losing.
Oh, okay, yeah.
Why am I losing? What am I doing? And also because obviously the inner life politics going on and stuff like that, that is still relevant. That is the only reason why I still have the app. I don't really give a damn if random people unfollow me. But if someone I know unfollows me, I immediately go like, okay, something happened.
Yeah,
so,
bitch.
Like,
or you son of a bitch.
You son of a bitch also happens to it. So point being that it was messing with my feed a lot. It was messing with my growth, and I knew that. And it was a plan tab se ki nahin, I'll just, you know, make another account. But then I lost that account.
Right.
Like, okay, might as well make two accounts. So I just made like very randomly. And when I made Girl Knows Her Food and I entered that scene, I saw the number of bloggers that are there in the city, the food bloggers, and I was like,
in Pune.
Oh my God, it's unreal.
Yeah, I've seen that.
Oh
scene.
Shit, it's so many food bloggers. I was okay, these are really good food bloggers, okay? Now, these are people who are actually writing about food.
Yeah.
That is the, I like clicking food, okay? So I am not, I'm very dramatic with my food, and I'll be like, listen, that blew my mind. I was, you know, taken, transported to some other planet and stuff. Like, I'll say all of that. But when it comes to describing taste and everything, I'll be like, spicy.
Karen and I were talking about it.
So, still,
because you also mentioned that you want to learn about it.
Yes, yeah, very much to. So. Because, see, honestly, there's no time anymore to, you know, kind of do something you love. So, learn about it in the sense that there's still, you know, like, there's this place in KP that opened. It's called Abyssian or something like that. Abyssian. Basically,
right,
that place
right.
does Ethiopian cuisine.
Ethiopian cuisine. Have
yeah.
you ever have you ever had? No.
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 no. Exactly no. my point. And when it came out, it's like, wait, is this a thing? You know, like, well, so.
I would like to. I mean,
yeah.
Yeah,
it's crazy,
yeah.
And you should see the pictures. It's not like the most appealing, but it's something that it's very interesting to look at. It's like this one big thali, and it has like various things, and I'm like, wait, what is this nonsense? They have the special kind of roti thing also going on. It's crazy. So, point being that, you know, the food scene has actually enabled, and it happened because of gym.
Because of
training.
Okay.
So when I started training.
So to you personally?
Yeah, personally.
Okay.
Because, see, we all have been in a space in our like lives when we're eating, and we're like, I will eat anything as long as it's there on the table, and I don't have a particular choice for it. And
okay.
it was like that for most of my life. I was like, butter, chicken, roti, dal, khatam.
Huh.
But I think when I started training, because there were days when I wanted to have a salad.
Right.
I didn't know that you could enjoy a salad so much. It's
okay.
crazy. Like if somebody does a salad right, salad can be the best thing to have.
Yeah,
like if
salads
you,
are actually very yummy.
They are yummy and the.
So are you talking purely in terms of taste, or maybe it gives you that thing that okay, you're doing good to your body while working out?
I think it's a good
combination,
of both
yeah.
things. But frankly, I'll be honest. Even when I have the chance to cheat, like okay, so it's in my head. So Sundays are cheat days.
Mm-hmm.
So even when I have a chance to cheat,
like Dwayne Johnson, do you eat big?
Oh, sushis.
Yeah.
Yeah, man.
Okay.
Not the sushi train, though,
yeah.
but yeah.
The
so
cookie train or whatever he does.
Oh,
man.
Oh my god,
yeah.
He's getting too hard.
No, don't do that, you'll get big, man.
I feel like I already have. So my point being, what was I saying?
You were saying that Sundays are your cheats.
Yeah, so like my point is that even when I do have the chance to cheat, there are going to be days when I feel like eating, say, light, I'll go pick a salad up.
Right.
Because I'm like,
yeah, not under that pressure that, okay, for cheat, you have to eat junk or
nothing.
I
will generally, properly, by my own heart, pick a salad up because I enjoy it. And
right.
it's something that I would have never understood had I not started training. Because after I started training, there's like this wide, so many options that I felt like you can eat properly and not feel bad.
What about alcohol?
I love my wine.
I like that pause.
I love my wine. It's okay. I'm been trying to quit, I'll be really honest, because it's... There's no problem per se, but there are things that you
Does
say.
It only happen on cheat days, or it's like, since you love your wine, so does it happen on a regular basis?
It used to happen only on cheat days, but now I'm just very, like, I'm under stress all the time, and I'm like, I need wine.
Okay. or you need wine, so let's be under stress.
Could be that.
Yeah?
Could
that's
be
how
that.
You look at it.
Yeah.
But, you know, like, small things, like yesterday my exams ended, so
yeah,
know,
pocket list
too,
yeah.
So I am there because I am now at a very comfortable space of my body where I'm like, I can
have it. Yeah.
You know, when I started training for a year, I didn't do anything wrong.
Mm.
You know, wrong is a very strong word actually,
yeah.
But I did everything right. You know, so like taking care of like little things and all of
by
that.
By the book earlier,
yeah. But it wasn't like I never starved myself or something, because that is something that I did all my life and it never worked for me. Never.
Yeah.
It never does.
I know
what
you're talking about. So, but yeah, food blogging. How did it start?
Yeah, so it happened because of the page, and then eventually I came in and I started posting like photos, and I had a lot of mal from my previous account. So initially it was all just all of that. And slowly I realized that, listen, it's something that I feel like I can do. Someday.
Right.
You know,
was it because of the response you were getting?
No, honestly, I don't get a lot of response on that account for some reason.
But it's a start. I mean,
I
see the account. It's people are... You are you getting engagement? That's what I really want to know. It can be small because...
No, surprisingly, I get more engagement for that account on my own account.
Okay.
But I don't get it on that account,
right.
Which is really weird. Like when
and
I
how old is that account? The food?
A year old.
It is not. Because people are blogging since, I don't know.
Exactly.
That's what you said, right? People,
exactly.
Right.
It's so hard, right?
It's very hard. It's very hard. And especially I've realized that, you know, making an account which you are the face of, right, which you can constantly... So it was my decision from day one that there will never be a single post or story on my food account that has my face in it.
Okay.
I can't afford to, because I've already been so, like, you can say stereotyped, or I've been already so, like, I've been the poster girl for, like, so many other things. This is something that is so close to my heart. I never wanted somebody to follow me because of the way I looked.
But think about it. What else can you do? See, let's see, three of us are food bloggers, right?
Mm-hmm.
In a city like Pune, what else can you do besides clicking pictures and writing stuff about food? How big of a connoisseur can you become, right? I mean, to be at that level, what can you do? I'm just thinking about
I'll tell you what people do.
Okay.
It's crazy.
Yeah.
It is crazy. And I'm telling you, it is dedication to the highest level. It's, college is not a dedication. This...
I'm sure.
Crazy. So first of all, Zomato is like a massive part of food blogging.
Mm-hmm.
Food blogging is not going to mean shit if you don't give the restaurant a review on Zomato.
Right.
Yeah. So like if, even if you have 10,000 followers on your food page on Instagram, a real proper foodie or a person who's in food, restaurants, whatever, the business, they will go to your Zomato and they will see the followers that you have on Zomato, and it is a proper...
Really?
Yeah, it's 3,000, 5,000 followers
people
on Zomato.
People religiously follow Zomato?
Yeah, yeah. They do. It's crazy. You should go and check some of the food bloggers who have, like, I think someone has 3,000 to 5,000 followers
on Zomato.
It's crazy.
Obviously,
it is
I
intense.
Feel like another 2 years Zomato followers is going to become a thing now. Like,
yeah, no, I think it is already a thing, but it's a very lesser known thing, because
right.
This is a thing only people who are constantly religiously on the app know about.
I'll tell you what you should do.
Yeah.
You should start a food podcast. You should totally do that. No, you should. You should. Is anyone doing that in Pune right now? No, you should. You should absolutely do that. Give it a thought later. Now, yeah.
I'm not really thinking about
yeah,
it.
Yeah,
my
yeah.
dad gave me this really awesome idea at one point. So my dad is like a big supporter of my page. He goes to random people and tells them. Yeah.
That's really cool.
So
that's,
sweet.
That's
he was
really
so cute,
cool.
You know.
You need
he was
telling
this to
man.
People in Punjab, dude. I was like... What?
So you that's crazy, yeah, because you need folks like these, man. What if your parents tell you that, okay, padh le, kuch kar le, chhod
de, itna jo bhi hai. Dude, Abhi, I feel like you can literally do anything under the sun and you can still make it like a business.
Yeah,
because
yeah, true.
Everything is open as long as you're good at what you do, you get your returns.
Yeah.
Yeah. So, he gave me this really cool idea. He told me, and if someone watches this, they'll take the idea. But it's okay, no problem, I don't mind.
Fuck
so,
it.
Yeah.
You started first.
No, it's okay. So he told me that what I should be doing is that if I'm whatever food ka photo I'm clicking, na, so suppose this is my plate, I'm clicking this couple. So I should go and make a video of the person, the chef who cooked it. And you should just make like a 1 minute video of what he's saying and how he did it, what is his, you know, inspiration behind the dish, or whatever. And he said, do it from the smallest to the biggest restaurant, because there's always some inspiration.
I think we are really new. We are just 10 episodes, 11 episodes old, right? What I really think, you were a bit skeptical that if I say that, people might take the idea, which is all right. I mean, you don't want your original idea, but then you realize that your idea isn't that original at the end of the day. Somewhere or the other, people are doing such stuff.
Yeah.
Maybe your father is a genius and
someone
he said, I don't know. I don't see.
No, people usually do these for restaurant promotions, like. The restaurant itself takes video.
Yeah, exactly. Right? Yeah, this even I know, because on Zomato, the proper videos of the...
Let's just say no one ever did that before, but you didn't start this and someone saw the video and started it immediately and you lost the, you know, first kill.
You know the
first
thing is in this world today, you can't ever be 100% original with anything.
Yeah, that's what I'm
yeah,
saying.
True.
What I'm really trying to say is let's not think like that. How about, you know... putting it in a different angle. I think what really matters and helps, I'm not an expert because people, we have just started, so I'm no one to, you know, wahi Vikram wali baat that you become a philosopher, but first, you know, become rich and then people will listen to you. But
who said this?
The previous guest, right?
Amazing.
Yeah, he was like, you know, people will only listen to you if you're rich,
yeah,
right?
Yeah.
It doesn't matter though, because
that
experience.
People will see your
only,
success and then
yeah.
No, but you know, that's happened with me too. Like someone, you know, I got accused of something really stupid very recently. And then I put a post up about, like there was a food cup post I put, linked it to my account. And someone said this thing, you know, they were like, I don't know why you make such a big deal about it. You have an iPhone XS. And I was like, wait. And I put up a post. I actually posted it on my story. I was like, privilege undermining talent. Since years now. This is unreal.
Yeah, people talk like that.
Yeah.
People talk like that. But, you know, again, getting to my point before. I was,
yeah, sorry.
Yeah. So, it's just that I think what really helps is building a community.
Yeah.
That will really help. See, for example, I told you about the podcast, right?
Mm-hmm.
Doesn't matter if 10 people next to you are you know, doing the same thing, even a podcast. So if you start a podcast, you know a podcast right here, right?
Mm-hmm.
You know, you are at one. Then I know you. Similarly, two, three. This community and people, you know, pushing each other up, I think that will give you a better platform because now everything is saturated. How many pictures can you click off one dish and tell people that, okay, this is better and my blog is better than the other person's blog?
You can't, yeah.
Instead, if you show your personality, your characteristics, maybe it will give you an edge. So that was my idea.
No, that is a very important thing actually. Jesus, people forget that even your Instagram profile needs to have a voice. It needs to have a character. You can't just be like posting some stuff and think that, okay, it will work.
This is, I think, the difference between my account and my food account. On my account, I'm so present.
Right.
You know, so I have a community on my account and it's a very strong one. I love it so much.
Right.
You know, I call it the fam and my friends.
That's new.
Yeah. But it's not new actually. It's a thing. The fam is a thing.
So
we
don't have a
fan. If I say fam, only 4 people or 10 people are like, hey, what's up?
So but even that's a fam, you know? Like that's how it starts.
That's how I like my fam, like less.
Yeah. No, but I don't have Insta fam, okay? So like
So when you say social life and real life, you know, you use these terms, I wanna know that. Why do you say social life and real life? Isn't your social life real? Like, you're clicking...
No, not for me.
No? That's what I really want to know. Because what you post, aren't you doing the same things while... Or you are posting for Instagram, which is all right. But it's like, I mean...
You know what I think? I think my social life is very real, but my real life isn't social, if that makes sense. Like, it is... what I do on Instagram is... I can't say filter, but there's a lot that is held back. If that makes any sense. Like,
no, it does.
It's like I have to think 100 times. Like there are
you things. Offending a community? Blah, blah, blah.
Yeah, like I'll tell you something really small. The other day, there's this picture of me and it was a very, very cute picture with me and my friends. But I had a smoke in my hand at that time. I was like, no, I'm not going to post it because I don't want to be... Like
should
I
we
said,
had smoke? Do you smoke? But are you cool smoking in front of the camera right now? I'm just sorry, I'm not telling you to, but
no,
shit, we should know. I've been pushing people that please.
He held on to the smoke.
I was like, someone just
smoking and I'm just gonna go
there were people who came and they were like, no, not in front of the camera, not in, I was like, fine, but unless I really wanted to. Now I don't want you to get the smoke because that'll be like very scripted. Oh, let's just smoke in front of the camera.
No, in fact, when you were telling me, I asked her if I could like go to the bathroom and pee and everything, and my actual question was like, could I get a smoke at some point of time?
Yeah, you can. So anyway, that picture with you.
Yeah, so I didn't post that, and because I don't know, all of a sudden Instagram has become a social responsibility. You can get taken on for anything. So I'm like, bitch, no.
You must be very scared, right?
I'm like, it has to be proper. And even when I'm doing everything properly, there are times when I do end up offending. Because I'll tell you the biggest angle on my own account being feminism. Oh my God. If I put up, and I do. This is something that I don't hold back ever. I will never. There are times when I've called out people just like, I get a horrible message now, like from a guy. I tag the account, I'll do everything. And there'll be people who will tell me that, listen, I don't think you should do that, you know. I'm like, listen, a guy cannot talk to me like that. And... not like, see, I'm not saying it's going to change him, putting him up on a story. It's not going to change him, that is for sure, because that's mind space he lives in. You can't change that.
No,
he has to at least think twice before talking to somebody else like that. He should know the power of social media in that respect, that you cannot text women like that.
But how many times are you going to do that?
Every single time. I do it every single time. I'm telling you, on my account
there is a better option. In my opinion.
Which is blocking?
No. The art of not actually giving a damn about it. Posting and keeping your phone down. Many people, I've heard it from celebrities. Because celebrities, when they get big, they get heat about every single thing. Because, see, first thing, if you are putting an opinion in front of people, one thing, you are putting an opinion in front of thousands of people. Maybe more than thousands. It's just not possible not to offend a particular person.
I'm
just saying.
Yeah. We're clubbing two things up. Okay, no, I think what you're saying is that when I put something up and the response that I get to it, no, that is okay.
Okay.
But I get a lot of shit for it.
Okay.
I do, from like someone. And honestly, the response that I get from my feminist posts are very civil, I'll be honest.
Okay.
The guys who respond to it, they'll be a little, you know, they'll be like, listen, they'll say whatever they're.
Men's rights activists. What kind of men? And what kind of posts are we talking about when you put feminists? I know about the Cosmo Wala thing that
you're
talking
about. Okay, the Cosmo one I got a very good response to
that. But yeah, but we'll talk about that.
Yeah.
But that will be more like, you know, telling women that, okay, you shouldn't, you know.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And actually, that's the first time I did it for, in terms of my...
Right.
Which
made sense to me. I'm like, I mean, okay, that's happening, that's good.
Yeah, no, it has to, because, and I did not realize, you know, calling yourself a feminist for all my life, I didn't realize there was this post that a feminist page put up, and it, listen, it blew my mind, I'll be honest.
Okay.
It was about male body positivity. And I read about it,
mm-hmm.
and it blew my freaking mind. I was like, I never thought about it like that. I'm like, listen, I get it. Women get it more.
Mm-hmm.
And I've got it all my life. I know what it feels like. But to not realize that this can happen. It has happened with men in front of me, and I've not realized that.
What are we talking about?
Like, you know, for their bodies, man
yeah,
boobs,
yeah.
stuff like that. And, you know, things that are out of the control of a guy. You...
No, no, because, you know what?
Used to have them.
I was a fat kid, man. It's just that I might not be like most of the people, because I was like, fuck it, I don't, you know, I don't care. It's okay if I don't have a neck, if I have, but I wasn't like, you know, towards wo wala ki, okay, estrogen zyada. So I was a fat kid.
Hmm.
So I, yeah, I had everything. I had layers,
so
man.
Like
it does. Maybe I was fortunate enough, or maybe I had that kind of, you know, environment where, you know, people were very, you know, I'm talking about my family. So they were more of an inspiration. So they were like, okay, they didn't tell me much, but, you know, just by looking at them, I was like, listen, I need to do something about myself. So I tried. I didn't change much.
Correct.
So I just got lucky. I mean, my height badhi, so I was mota hota tha.
That's what I'm saying. That's
yeah.
what, you know, my opinion about guys was like, they're chill about, like, in any case, most of the things, like I'm saying as a woman, when you see a guy in a strenuous kind of a situation, it's like, okay, he'll handle it.
Yeah.
It's a thing. But to not think about the guys who can't, it's like, it's weird. And you know, like my own boyfriend, we're talking about him right now. There's so many times when he tells me about school, you know, he was an extremely fat kid. Oh my God.
Right now he's a big buff dude,
yeah,
man.
Yeah,
he's like, yeah, I've seen him.
He's nuts now. Now I can't stop him. No, nothing's stopping him. So, and I'm like, listen, you're getting bigger. Stop it. But no, he was crazy. He needed 3 seats, you know, and the Mojo Rickshaw ka hota too, you know, just makes it like one of him. It was really bad. And there's so many times when he told me about what used to happen with him in school, and I just hear it.
People used to call me Motu every single time. I've grown up listening to the word Motu.
Bullying. Yeah.
No one could bully me, that's separate.
Like
that.
Your father was like a cop.
Your father's a cop?
Was like, he retired now.
Oh,
so but that you know, that's where I'm getting at. So I want to know, Naman, telling something. Where should, so you know, people were telling you that, okay, Cosmo, my girlfriend, you know, she kind of, you know, she parted ways when we were in a party, and just because I was having a cosmopolitan.
Yeah, yeah.
You know what? Now I want to know that, where do friends draw a line? Because I'm sure you have close, thick buddies, right?
Mm-hmm.
And do you make fun of your friends? Because, you know, there, for me, no line exists. I'm not lying. Okay, you can judge or whatever,
yeah,
right?
Yeah.
But when it comes to friends, and when it comes to humor, in pure, I don't ever wish to harm a friend of mine.
Yeah.
But when we're joking,
yeah.
Have you ever cracked jokes on your friends, on their bodies? Or we go all out. We go like, ist, every ist, racist. Knowing that, you know, we have that understanding, we don't mean it, but we say
that's
shit.
The thing, boys,
haven't you ever done that? I just want to know. Maybe that's me, but I've seen many people do that, and it wasn't our upbringing. We just were comfortable cracking such jokes.
Yeah.
Made sure that no one else gets hurt by that.
Yeah.
We're not doing that in public.
Yeah.
But when, yeah, so I want to know, when does this thing tell you that, okay, let's not cross the line or whatever?
You know, I think when it comes to this, no, this is where...
friends, purely in terms of
friends.
Yeah,
just friends. I'll be like my best friend right now is gaining a lot of weight. So, I think what has changed for me, that 10 years ago, I would do this, probably. But ever since I've realized, and ever since I've kept, like, my posting of feminism is so much, that responsibility is automatically come inside.
Yeah.
Like, it is...
You can't
gone
anymore.
And even when, I'm not saying that there's no line, but you know, like, I know that I can, like, I'm a very sarcastic person,
mm-hmm.
and I can get cocky sometimes,
mm-hmm.
moody. So I might say something, but this particular area of, you know, social responsibility, not just on media, but in my real life, is so much that automatically...
It has changed you?
Yeah, completely. That's what I feel like. But
yeah,
once you start advocating something...
You'll be called a hypocrite then?
No. It's... But Abhimanyu, it's like my question is, why should we wait for somebody else to call us?
Makes sense.
It makes me feel like one in the first place. I think it's very important for me to, that whole looking at yourself in the mirror business is very real for me, I'll be very honest. That's why I'm a really bad liar.
Right.
So when I lie to someone, I have an issue that is so
guilt.
Guilt is unreal. It's crazy. And even for the smallest thing, if I lie now, I'll be like, no, I have to tell them. I have that whole looking. Not
you can't
proper.
Keep secrets?
No, I can't keep secrets at all. Very bad. Very bad.
Gossip.
No, I can't. And this is the difference. Now, see, gossiping, see, it's a secret. And also, you have to tell me something about your personal life, your family.
Like, GOT. Don't tell anyone. And what did Sansa do?
No, yeah,
so,
GOT, I take very seriously that I will never, I know what would happen to me if someone told me a spoiler, and that's something like,
you've seen the last episode, I'm sure you have, right?
Yes.
So, he tells Sansa that don't tell anyone, right?
Stupid girl.
She goes, and she tells the smartest brain on the planet.
Oh my god,
so,
that,
you know,
woman.
That guy.
And then, you know, what's the guy's name? Lord Varys, what?
Yeah, the bald guy.
I think they are having a conversation, and then I lost my train.
They were having a conversation about Sansa that should we make...
No, okay, I remember he said this thing, you know, he asked Tyrion how many people know about it, and I think Tyrion said it, including us, seven. Like,
yeah, I was counting like who...
Yeah,
all.
Same thing, and I'm like, wait, and then the next thing is like, okay, now the entire world knows about it, you can't tell seven people and not like tell the world, so no, I'm a good secret keeper when it comes to like personal stuff about your family and stuff like that, but, you know, if there's you and there's her... And, you know, there's something about her that she needs to know.
Hmm.
But you're like, no, don't tell her.
Yeah.
I'll be like, listen, you need to know. Very much like that, man. So, yeah. I'm a very, like, I draw a line there where I try to, like, figure out what I can, what I cannot do. So, coming back to it, it's like with my, now, like, with my best friend, he's gaining weight every day. Listen, don't do this. Don't crib about it if you're not going to do anything about it. Stop. Like, listen, what? Like, apple cider vinegar. Yes or no. It's crazy. Like, now it has become such a... Because there is body positivity involved. There's gymming involved. There's these categories, like, you know, when I'm... Like, these things are a part of my life. So, I can become, like, a preacher for it. But then, no. Making fun, me.
No.
I can't. Just can't.
No, no one should. But, you know, sometimes...
Ho jata hai, mujhe pata hai. I get, like... Two drinks of wine, I'll be like, I'll say something.
I was just talking about that because I don't want to lose that kind of bond. That is also very important. Because you need to take your friend's case at the end of the day.
Yeah, of course.
Anyway, getting back to you, tell me about your gym and diet routine. Yeah, I've heard a lot of, you know, ups and downs changes. Yeah, let's talk about that.
So much. I've tried so many diets. Apparently, there was this metabolism boosting diet that I did. And it's just an
What did you eat in your metabolism boosting?
This happened when I reached a plateau, you know, like you don't lose weight after a while. I was like gripping so much. I was like, I need to. I need the dream board and everything. It was not happening. Freaking Instagram.
It's, you know, maybe guys always imagine themselves topless, like that's the kind of body I want, so they want pecs, they want the pack, you know. So maybe girls always, is it true that they imagine, you know, that hourglass bikini figure
every single time?
Forgetting that, okay, this is your body, but you want that kind
you,
of body.
Yeah,
yeah, yeah. So
no, but I don't imagine that. Girls do, and I did at one point of time, but now I've become like very, like, like good booty and abs and stuff like that. I'm okay. Anything that is achievable, I want to do.
Okay.
Like, I can't.
And sustainable.
And sustainable, too, yes. Abs are not sustainable. No. Okay, but anyway. No, dude, how are abs sustainable? Pani piyo to chale jaate hain. This is real weird, yaar. Nonsense.
Showing abs is not sustainable.
Yeah.
Abs sab kyo karenge bhi honge abhi. Man ki aankhon se.
So no, the gym diet is very what's the question?
We were talking about your fitness routine, the metabolism diet.
Oh my god.
Just tell me about everything that you've done so far, because you were I hope you don't mind, you were big and now you're like this. So yeah. What happened?
Okay, I haven't mentioned this. I wanted to be an actor.
Oh, fantastic. Well, wanted as in done with it. Don't want to be an actor anymore. Is this a platform, social media that you once, you know?
No, it wasn't. It wasn't. Because maybe today, see, from the time of social media that I'm coming from, you didn't get acting jobs based on your profile.
No.
Today, maybe yes.
Yeah.
Very true. Yeah. You do. Now I get like messages for auditions. Like even when I'm not trying to do anything, I'm getting audition messages.
Really?
Yeah. Every day, you know, this is shoot, yeah, shoot, in this country, this, all of that is happening. So
okay.
It was very cool. Like, I wish that
and
I was
legit
the same.
Ones or just
no, some legit ones, you know.
Okay.
Of course, non-legit ones also there, was
yeah.
Other, but, you know, someone like some random person, 5 lakhs person. Shut up. So I'll be like, point being that it's a good thing or a bad thing that I don't know. I'm not in that space anymore. I was like, why was this not happening back then when it should have happened? So that's what I'm telling you. Today, Instagram is a very good platform to get yourself exposed. But also, it can be really bad if you want good movies.
Right.
People who are looking for fresh faces don't want an Instagram model who has like 100k followers or something.
Oh,
fresh
yeah, that makes sense.
It's crazy.
Mostly going for nepotism.
Yeah. Obviously, like a lot of girls, the girl who's going to get launched with Sushant in that movie, the Fault in Our Stars remake.
Should they're making an Indian remake of?
Yeah.
Why the hell do they do that, man? Why?
It's crazy. It's very. I was very disappointed.
It's beyond me.
Though I haven't read that book, but I've heard like.
Have you seen the movie?
I've seen
no.
The movie.
Oh, I just, the only thing that I know about that movie is, okay, that's all I know about that, because that's what you see everywhere,
Okay, the book was crazy. I've read both the book, and I've seen the movie as well, and the book was so
good. Oh, you read? Good.
Yeah, I used to, now it's a little. And then I saw the movie, and I was like, okay, this movie does justice for the book. Very rarely it happens, man.
It did,
for me personally, it did justice. Listen, the guys cried in the movie, man. All the boys, the entire theater, which are, all the girlfriends have gotten their boyfriends, and everybody was sar pakad ke andar enter hue the, sar pakad ke nikle. They were like, shit, man, what a movie. Everybody was crying. I was like, what is up with this?
I'll tell you two movies where I have cried.
Yeah.
Rang De Basanti, and you just can't help it. That movie is very overwhelming.
I know,
very.
Not a human being if you don't cry in that movie.
Rang De Basanti and Baagbaan.
Same! I cried in my. Oh my god, the speech?
I don't know. I was just like on a roll. But, and you know. And I was not.
Were you fat at this time?
I don't remember. But stop imagining me. Like, stop imagining a fat me crying in the middle of a movie. It's just that I wasn't. Crying, but you know,
tears.
Rang De Basanti was more like goosebumps and crying. But the uncle sitting next to me in Baagbaan, he was howling. I think uske bachche uske aapko kar rahe the. I'm not lying, dude. And you know, I looked at him and my tears went. They dried, man. They dried off, and I looked at the uncle and I couldn't, you know, I just burst out laughing. And then while moving, he just, you know, did this on my hair. That dekh liya tune maine. Kya sharam
jaati hai. Shit. Point being that. You, oh my god, it's difficult.
You wanted to act, so
yeah. So my, I was saying
transformation.
That, like,
we were talking about the transformation.
Yeah. So what happened? So I auditioned for Yash.
Oh, nice.
Yeah, and
whistles.
Yeah. So I auditioned for them at 86 kgs.
Okay.
So,
but were they looking for?
No, I'll tell you what happened.
That kind of.
No, what they were looking for, they just looked at my pictures and the pictures that I sent them. And pictures are deceptive.
You didn't want them to know that you are 86 kilos.
I'll tell you what. I have been shooting with my best friend's a photographer. I've been shooting with him, been photo shoots with him since years now. So immediately that they asked me for my photos, whatever I had, I sent them. So whenever he shot me for photos, he's made sure that, you know, I don't look like out of place or really fat or whatever. So they were automatically photos that didn't really give away my body type.
Right.
So I just very randomly, like, you know, I say,
just
for the sake of it. And they actually called me.
Nice.
And I was like, shit. But just because I am overweight doesn't mean that I won't go to a Yash Raj audition, right?
Yeah,
exactly. That's what happened. And so I went. And they gave me Anushka Sharma's script from Rabne Mana Dilori.
Okay.
I read it and stuff, and there
so
was
I'm sure you must have seen the movie before. Right? You knew the lines and all.
Yeah, I knew.
Okay.
And I knew that scene also was one of my most favorite scenes.
Okay.
She's shouting at him and everything. So I was like, okay, this is the way I can use. Problem was just one when that happened.
You wait. You were fat.
And they told me in the most. I can't even reproduce the way they gave it to me.
Okay.
And you know, they told me that they loved me. Which was great. So I knew that, okay, I can do this at some point of time in my life. But they very clearly told me that if you're looking to become a mainstream actress or even a supporting character or whatever you want to do in the film industry commercially, and
right.
It's not theater, it's not art, nobody's going to take you like this.
I don't blame them. That's okay.
Because
script has been written and whatever the script demands, right?
Yeah.
If they are looking for such character, they will take that character.
Yeah.
Yeah, like Bhumi Padnekar. Padnekar. Yeah, Padnekar. She was in Tamaraki Harsha at like 94 kilos or something.
So that demanded, right? The script demanded such character. Yeah.
Exactly. I don't have a problem with the fact, but it was such an eye-opener in terms of the fact that listen, Naman, ho gaya. Entire life, various diets, gymming of 2-3 days, sab ho gaya. Go back to fucking Pune and do something. So I came back, I joined the gym, I joined Gold's, jahan pe bhi Nitro hai. So I joined Gold's and it was, I had 42% body fat on me.
Okay.
And
you just said 80 something kilos, you don't need to hesitate when you say 40
and
something.
No,
fat
and I'm hesitating because I still remember that day.
Right.
You know, it was really sad. And so basically then I was like, I don't want to do anything with myself, so take a trainer, started working out with him and everything. Results started showing very fast.
Okay.
Very quickly. So from day 1 to day 30, what happened is that nothing changed on my scale. So I didn't weigh myself in those 30 days, okay? So on day 30, 84, whatever I was. And then on day 30th, I was like 1 kg down on the scale.
Right.
And I started crying. I started howling in the gym. I was like, what the fuck? I did so much. Socket every day. Nothing is happening.
It was really bad.
What happened is that my trainer took a body analysis again. And he showed me the amount of fat I had lost and the amount of muscle I had gained.
Right.
And the amount of fat that I had lost was around 6%.
Okay, that's huge.
Okay, 6 kgs.
6 pounds or...
Yeah, something. What is this? There was a bar. It was, I think, on that it shows the amount of kgs and fat that you have.
Right? Mostly it's in pounds. Usually they
something
do it in
like
pounds.
That.
Okay.
Point being that it was quite huge. It wasn't 6 kgs. No, it wasn't. So, I was like, okay, this makes sense. And then I was like, okay, muscle is a thing. So like puri umar maine to suna bhi nahi tha, you know, like I was like,
they automatically associate men usually that, okay,
that,
yeah, you know,
like, so like muscle, like where is the muscle, I don't see shit and everything. And he's like, listen, it's gonna, so eventually it became less about losing fat,
right.
It became more about gaining muscles. I started enjoying strength training so much. I was eating chicken all the time. I started having protein shakes, all of that came into my life instantly, you know. And it's not like I tried to get it in my life. When you're putting in that much amount of effort, these things will come naturally. That's what I tell my best friend. I was telling you, and when I told him to go to the gym, he's like, nahi, abhi nahi, my diet pe control. I was like, there is no way in hell, psychologically speaking, you will be able to control your diet if you have not started training. Thoda wo, it works on your mind, you know, when you're putting in so much effort, khud man nahi karta khana khane ka, it's not like the bad food. So yeah, instantly, like, you know, in that 1 year, and my next birthday, I was down to like looking, you know, proper, like I could act now and everything. But what happened in that 1 year is that I did a couple of other auditions and I was in touch with, so basically I studied at Active Repair School.
Studied at?
Anupam Kher has a school in Bombay. It's an acting school called Active Repair.
Okay.
So that's...
I've heard of it.
So you do a 3-month course of acting over there. And so that's where I was before the Yash Raj audition.
Right.
And the Yash, I'll tell you what happened is that in that building, so the Active Repair is on the 2nd floor, Yash Raj office on the 3rd.
Okay.
So it's like in the same building. So that's how that audition came through. So while I was there, while I was in Bombay, then I get this audition, then I did a couple of other auditions. I spoke to a lot of my friends from Active Repairs who were still, people who had come down from Singapore and America for this. And I was like, okay, great, this is a thing. And they are still over there. All of those guys are struggling every single day.
It's with every other career
it's
stream.
Crazy.
That's what happens. Yeah, not just acting. Yeah,
actually,
yeah.
It is, quite frankly. But I'll tell you what, Abhi, I really, really think that at some point of time, you've got to get very realistic about it.
You have to give up and like this. Give
up se zyada, move on will be a
move
better
on,
better
yeah, exactly. Yeah. More like trying to understand if this is a space that it's a, okay, either you have to be like really, if you feel like super rich and you can afford to like give in 10-20 years of your life to this, and it's okay, it's fine.
And then there's also that age bracket, they say ki ye time
and although I do think that is also changing very slowly. I think that's changing a little bit, like with Nargis Fakhri when she came and she was 30 rockstar. So I was like, okay, theek hai. So point being that I was like, ki kitna? How much longer do you wait for that one thing to come? And before that only, what had happened with me is that I had been to a couple of parties and it just wasn't me. I realized very, very, very quickly that even if I...
The lifestyle isn't for you.
No. I get it, man. Like, the amount of... See, you've spoken to me for like over, what, 30 minutes, an hour now. Do you... Can you just imagine me sitting on a table and being anything other than myself?
I can't say anything with surety because,
yeah.
you know, things change.
Yeah, they do.
What if tomorrow you get a call and you were like, oh shit, I was dreaming about this. Like, I wanted this
to
happen.
See, that's what I'm telling you, that I'm ready. Even my friends know this, that if it comes across to me at some point of time, at any point of time, even at 40, 50 in my life, because I want to act so bad.
Exactly.
I will, in the, like, happily, you know, I'll be like, okay, let's kill this thing and everything. All of that will happen. But to stay in that industry for a stipulated amount of time and bust it.
How about, see, what if you are getting into this purely out of love for acting, right?
Hmm.
You want to act. Mostly, I think why people burn out, because they want the lifestyle, they want parties and all.
Mm.
You couldn't adjust,
mm.
like you couldn't, you know, you couldn't even acclimatize.
The thing is, you have to be very fake over there. You can't, because
who knows, man?
Not
who
accept
knows?
You for who you are.
What if that's the game? What if that's how you get to know more people and then you get the roles? Because all those people who've got their breaks, right? I know a few, they haven't done like good after first movie.
Mm.
They, no one knows them.
Yeah.
They're just gone, disappeared, right?
You have to be really, really talented
even,
for you to stay on.
Plus,
you'll get that first, but then second is not guaranteed.
So that was a smart move that you did and you left. But there are people who are crazy passionate about it and they won't. And eventually, maybe they won't get apni youth mein ya us beauty mein, they won't get a role. But maybe 35, 40,
Nahas
they will get.
And
see, and look at them.
Crazy,
look at
man.
Them. Where?
But this has happened. My mom, Tandi, we were watching some movie. In which she saw this one lady and she said, wait, pause, who is this? She saw, she's like, so my dad used to have a clothes store at one point and apparently he had a supplier whose wife wanted to be an actress.
Okay.
And she was like, oh, she was trying since that time to get a role and it's been about like 20 years
crazy.
For that
wow.
thing. And she's like, she finally got a role in a movie.
Mm.
And I was like, 20 years? And she was a proper auntie, like a housewife kind
mm-hmm.
of she was doing. But I was like, dedication, man, like 20
amazing,
years.
Amazing, man. That's really, you know, but really kudos to this guy. I was telling about my friends from
right.
Singapore and I'm like, oh my God, it is so lovely. It might be demotivating for me, but for them to be so motivated, it is amazing. And you know, like little things they do, yaar, serial mein ho gaya, commercial ho gaya, whatever, little things.
I think you have to do all that. We always think of ourselves ki, bhai star, movie mein ban jana hai, bada banner karna hai. Big Boss, main nahi jaunga kabhi.
Oh, no, no,
dude.
No, no.
Have you ever have a thought of going to Roadies or Spritzville?
I auditioned for Roadies.
MTV. Really?
That's cool, man. But
Rodi
Mani too.
I have auditioned for Rodi's at a very good time, actually.
See, that's what people say. It's so, there's never a good time. Once a
Rodi
auditioner,
really
always a Rodi auditioner.
No,
you've auditioned for Rodi's, done.
Shit, Sachi, I have that video still, you know, like, and my friends. So
let's not, you know, deviate. Let's not. Otherwise, you know.
No, I am very curious.
We have to have a Naman season 2.
Oh my God, this will never end. Actually, this will never end.
That,
point being, fitness, I'll bring it back.
Yeah.
So, in that 1 year, I'll tell you why I did not stick to it also.
Uh-huh.
Was because so many things were happening at the same time. I became a very basic person, if that makes any sense.
How? I
Like, I went from someone who wanted attention.
Right.
I wanted to be a movie star. Or I wanted people to look at me. I wanted to be thin. I wanted to wear good clothes.
Hmm.
I went from being all of that to someone who just wanted to have a peaceful life. So,
that's,
you know, like, the place that I am at today is so amazing, Abhimanyu, from the point of view that I just really want things to be as simple as possible around me.
Yep.
Like, if I get it in one go, this thing is going to be a part of my life. If I don't, then I'm like, okay.
Yeah, it's all about eliminating
yeah,
stuff
yeah.
that you don't require.
Dude, toxicity, negativity, all of that, I can't stand it anymore. You're
I even embrace them. They are a part. It will happen. You will meet people who won't give you good vibes.
Yeah.
Fuck it.
But you embrace those people?
Sometimes I have to. I just, it's me. It's purely me. It's
yeah.
pure. Sometimes I know people who are really close friends. Negative as fuck. I'm not lying. But I'm not one of those who's like, keep negative people away. I don't do that. People say that if you want to, you know,
mm-hmm.
progress, it's entirely dependent on, you know, your circle.
Yeah.
That's what is really prevalent nowadays. People
yeah.
are talking about that.
Yeah.
I somehow don't think like that because I know a few people. They give you bad vibes. You will get the jealousy vibe. But at the end of the day, they're my friends and they've always been with me. I don't care.
But
I'm going to take them along. It's
you,
okay.
You're going to have to make the choice, right? My boyfriend could be negative today, but I can't dump him. You know, my best friend could be negative and he is a lot of times, you
yeah.
know, because... And best friends, more so, because best friends have that whole... I feel like these days best friends have become more possessive about you than your partner, you know? So it's like... And so am I about him. So it happens with him too. And those are the troubles of my life, you know, when they come. But those are the troubles I choose.
Right, exactly.
You know, you're like, you can't leave this person because, you know, they don't understand who you are or they just don't understand that, you know, your actions or whatever.
Mm.
You can't. But I'm just talking about people... You have a choice to not.
Exactly. So this negativity that you get from, let's say, social media, right?
Yeah.
You have an option to completely ignore that, you know, and go further, like move ahead.
Mm.
But there are people, sometimes I remove them because of things they've done, trust issues, whatever. But sometimes I know that, okay, this person does not give me a good vibe. I just can't, you know, my heart doesn't allow me to, you know, just, okay, you're going to be with me as long as you can be with me.
Exactly.
So that's okay. Again, we are just, you know, we just always, but I want to talk about intermittent fasting with you. Yeah. Because you, yeah, because I've done that like for a very long period of time.
Yeah. How long?
So on and off, it became a lifestyle. Now I don't do that anymore. I don't go to the extremes.
Yeah.
So I have been to the extremes of having my eating window. That'll be like, 6 hours.
Oh man.
Six
okay,
hours.
Yeah.
And then I realized that, okay, yeah, it has a profound effect on your body.
Yeah.
No doubt about it.
Yeah.
No doubt about it. I won't give the gyan about growth cells and all because growth hormones because I don't know it. I've just read about it,
yeah. Yeah.
you know, blogs.
Yeah.
I won't go out that you should do it or you shouldn't do it. But then I realized that I will never go to extremes because then I started learning about my body.
Mm.
So when I got to know about my body, I was like, even 12-hour window is good for me. Since
yeah.
I don't need any, you know,
yeah.
drastic changes in my body, I
yeah.
don't want. So I have this lifestyle to maintain. I have this frame to maintain. I don't want to get big. I don't want to get small.
Mm.
Whatever.
Mm.
So yeah, that for me, that eating window was fine. And first thing, black coffee in the morning doesn't work for me.
No, why?
No, it doesn't work for me. I don't know. It doesn't suit me.
No, when you say it doesn't work for you, it makes you uneasy.
No. It gives me that focus. I'm like, but. The long-term effect, right?
Yeah.
Something or the other in my body is always messed up. And the day I stopped this, right?
Yeah.
First thing.
Yeah.
Maybe my body is not that, you know, well accustomed to having, you know, some acidic thing
okay.
in the morning, right. first thing.
Okay.
So I prefer a breakfast
yeah.
first
yeah.
and then coffee. Then I'm good with it. Though the focus-wise thing, it's amazing.
Amazing.
The first thing you,
yeah.
I never wake up and have black coffee in the morning. Never. Ever do that. People used to warn me that don't do that. I was like, listen, it's doing good to me because I was working a lot, right?
Yeah.
It was giving me that focus.
Yeah.
But it wasn't that helpful. So
okay.
I always, yeah. So how did it work for you and what was your eating window?
My eating window was
16-8 is, you know,
yeah.
it's like the typical.
It's
yeah.
the typical, but that lasted. I very slowly realized that it's very easy for me to do that window.
Right.
So it went on for a while, also because I had a very, very bad sleeping schedule. So I used to sleep at 4 or 5 in the morning every
never
day.
Do that.
It's so bad. Yeah, it's all gone now.
Never do that. He's a late sleeper as well.
Yeah. No, it's so bad for your mind, first of all.
Sometimes, you know, it's like, you know, while we are doing this, so I have to give us some ideas for the cover or something. So I'm up sometimes. It's very rare that I'm up
yeah.
till late, you know. Earlier I used to, I was
just
a fucking nocturnal animal at one point in time,
yeah.
but now, yeah, not anymore. So, I texted her at 3,
yeah.
an immediate response. I was like, fuck,
same,
dude, just
same,
sleep,
same.
Dude, what the hell is wrong with you?
Same, even my friends know that, you know, like, they'll text me at any point of time in the day, no response. Ratko,
yeah.
instant, there and then. I was like, dude, what is wrong with you? So I had a very bad lifestyle and then Ratko, na, what started happening is that most of my eating window was going away there only.
So you're eating at night, Ratko?
No. Like, I was, so suppose I said, my eating window ended at, suppose, 11.
11
p.m.
Yeah,
okay.
Of course, yeah.
So, if I started, like, if I'm awake till, say, 4, 5, 6 in the morning,
mm-hmm.
half of it is already gone. So I don't have to work on staying hungry when I wake up, because
mm-hmm.
I was waking up at 1, 2.
Mm-hmm.
So like it was so easy for me to do
yeah.
it. I was like, anyway, I don't have to sleep, so I'm not eating. So I was like, time to push it now. So
mm-hmm.
I took it to 17, 14,
right.
I took it to 18, and it was still working out for me. The reason why I stopped doing it.
16, 8.
Yeah, is
okay.
because of the fact that I understood very quickly that I understood the calorie deficit.
Okay.
That it, what IF is basically doing, it has a very good effect on your body, like you said.
Yeah.
Very good. But the way I look at it, it just makes your job easier of maintaining a deficit. Because you are automatically eating so much less. So my point being, so what I started doing after that is, there was this one day where I gave it a shot. I was like, one week where I gave it a shot. I was like, let's see if doing a deficit.
Right.
I won't maintain a window.
Mm.
I'll eat whatever I want to.
Mm.
I'll just do a proper deficit. Now,
right.
calorie counting is also very typical. You know, it's tricky. You can't like...
You can't. Do you have a scale? No?
I can never become that anal. And you know, I follow this blogger called Sheena Fit on Instagram. Do you know her?
Sheena Fit.
She's amazing. She's amazing.
From Pune?
Yeah.
Okay.
She's crazy. Her and Shivangi Bhatnagar both are really
Shivangi cool. Bhatnagar, I've met. Like, she
yeah.
used to come to Recomp.
Right? Yeah, yeah,
yeah,
yeah. Her, yeah, yeah,
yeah.
yeah. Same. Oh,
yeah.
Man, you were at Recomp. Like, I remember.
And Multifit. I've seen her at Multifit as well.
Yes, correct. She was
yeah.
a trainer over there.
Yeah.
So, Shivangi Bhatnagar, in my entire life, I feel is my only fan moment till
okay.
It's like when I saw her, I was like, okay, and I properly behaved like, you know, oh no, no, my God, like that. And I was like, okay, this is what it feels like. And I feel so unapologetic about it, because she's completely, you know, these both of these women, by the way, they encourage you to, you ask them any question about fat loss, you know, like, why am I not losing weight anymore? What is going wrong with my body? What do I do to lose weight?
Hmm.
You will get only one answer, calorie deficit. You will always get that answer. There's no other answer they give you.
That's the only
Yeah,
answer.
That is. And I was like, listen, I think I should stop killing myself for this.
Hmm.
You know, starving myself into not eating and try to maintain a deficit. And
yeah.
I did that for 1 week. It worked for me, and I realized that what I need to do is just maintain a window that I can sustain for the rest of my life.
Hmm.
Simple as that.
Yeah, that's
you know,
easy.
Like
yeah,
you said,
yeah.
12 hours.
Yeah,
it's easy peasy, super.
Right.
I think when you just get into a lifestyle of eating on the same time every day, stop eating at the same time, it's instantly going to do very good effects for your body. Like,
plus,
so.
I also believe that, you know, it'll be very, you know, philosophical, but nature has intended a way for us.
Hmm.
At night we need to sleep. My father always tells me, because you know, I always listen to people who have maintained good health. Some people are just old, but they are like, you know, unhealthy as fuck.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
So if they start giving me gyan andar and out of respect, I'm like nodding and all,
yeah.
but under, I'm like, shut the fuck up, old man. But some people are, you know, they have, it's not that they don't get fall sick or they don't have, you know, whatever,
mm.
sickness, disease, whatever, but they know how to, you know, get through,
mm-hmm.
and they have a way, still maintaining their physical
yeah.
activity
yes,
routine, right?
Yes.
So some people, they tell me that, okay, raat hote hi, your body needs sleep and wake up when sun rises.
Mm.
Very simple thing, cliche, must have been said a gazillion times, right?
Mm.
But it matters. You need, when you get up 6-7, I'm not saying go hardcore 4-5,
yeah,
and
yeah, yeah.
go to bed by 10-30, 11-12, whatever your
yeah.
time is. So, and
poor thing.
get up at 7, see the sunrise, go out, take
yeah.
the fresh air.
Yeah.
It does give you a perspective.
Vitamin
it does. Yeah, even that's like, you know,
no.
basically
Pune
yeah,
my injury is because of vitamin D.
Oh shit, let's talk about that. Yeah, tell
it's
me about
crazy.
It.
So
your knees.
My knees. No, first is my back, my lower back. That went out last year. It was completely out for a very long time.
What do you mean when you say out?
What I mean is that, okay, it sounds very serious, no? Not
back is always serious. Back is always
it
serious.
It is, and honestly, because, more so because anything else in your body.
Knees replaced with that.
Knees replaced bhi ho jata hai, knees. The injury ke saath, you can even train.
Yeah, you can. There's a different way to
yes,
train.
Yes, exactly.
With back injury, you can.
You can do nothing.
No.
Nothing, there's not one exercise you can do. So my back started paining, and I was like, oh my god, something has happened. And what is that exercise? Push the
tricep push
kettlebell up.
Kettlebell swings.
Yeah, kettlebell swings. Yeah,
yeah,
correct. So I was doing it with a 45.
Okay.
And
so you hurt yourself actually.
I don't think that's what did it, honestly. Because
okay.
1 year down the line, today, when I sat with my physio, not today, like 2 weeks back, when she explained to me my body, I got it that it wasn't the swing.
Okay.
Really? So basically that happened and I went to...
But the effect showed immediately after that disastrous category.
Yeah.
So did you... And it's been how long?
For the back, one and a half.
1.5 years. But did you rehabilitate your back injury?
Yes, I did. That's what I'm saying. That's what I'm going at. So what happened is eventually I got an MRI done.
Hmm.
Because you have to understand what's really wrong. Because a lot of three doctors I tried to fix it with physio and whatever, but it never went away. So I had to understand what is up. So I, in my personal suggestion for the rest of my life, MRIs are expensive.
Hmm.
But if you haven't gotten your answer for an internal injury by one or two doctors max, get an MRI done.
Yeah.
It's like, fine, screw the, like, you end up spending so much on stupid things, you know, it's your body, man, like, I'm like, just go get it done, because it just removes every single doubt that you might have. And then I got it done, and then I realized that the MRI scan showed that I have an annular tear.
Okay.
An annular tear is basically where your tissue kind of, the vertebra kind of pushes through my L5. Your tissue,
okay,
the spinal cord, so there's a tear over.
So is it lower back or upper?
Lower back. Yeah. So and that kind of pinches.
Okay.
Me, you know, so it,
every
like
time you lift weight or it's just
it's there.
Okay.
It's there. So now also I know, like, it's not there anymore. The pain is not there, but I can still feel that little one pinch, you know, in my back. So then I went to my fourth physio and I told her that so she gave me exercises and everything.
Right.
And I asked her like 10,000 times, will I be fine when I'm sick? She said, listen, it's a very common thing. Everybody has it.
Right.
It's going to go away. I was like, okay, theek hai, chalo. It went away.
Mm.
Now, what went next was my knee. So there's this machine in my previous trip called the stepper.
The stepper. Yeah. Stairs, right?
Yeah.
They keep on.
Yeah. I'm used to be like a big stepper person. Okay. Like I everybody in the gym knew. Like my favorite go to cardio. Sweat like shit.
Yeah.
So amazing. So there was this time when I went crazy wanting to lose weight. I think it was my birthday, or I think I was going for a shoot to Dubai. Something like that was happening. And it was the Dubai thing. So I went on the stepper and I used to, like, the speed used to be 11, 12, and I think I busted my knee around the time. And then eventually what happened is that my knee started aching, I started going to physios again. Never went away, the knee pain. I never got an answer. So they all told me that you have a problem, patella problem, uska wo tear ho gaya ya kuch to ho gaya, and it'll go away with exercises.
Right.
They made me do exercises. The exercises did help for a while.
Yeah.
But the permanent solution nahi aa raha tha, and nobody, see, my problem is, as a person, who, if whenever something goes wrong with me, I have to understand the cause. If you don't tell me the cause, why something as small as Instagram, me losing my Instagram account, I want to know. Like, today, till date, it's my best guess that that's why it happened.
Yeah.
Nobody ever told me why it happened.
Hmm.
So it's like, I want to know what, kyun ho raha hai, so that I don't repeat it again. Shivangi's dog physio, she told me to go to a physio. Shivangi, I met her one day and I just told her, she saw me limping or something. She's like, I did something to my knee. She's like, what's up? My knees are really bad. And she's like, go to my physio. And she gave me a number and everything. I went to the physio. So I entered the physio and this woman is looking at me. I have not even said anything. And she goes like, is it your knees? I was like, what?
That's a job.
That's a job. And you know, like, that's where you know that you've arrived at the right place. You know, it's so important to have the right person look at you. And in the next 15 minutes, she figured out everything that was wrong with my
body.
Everything. And there were a million things I'd tell you. My one leg is shorter than my other leg.
That is a prevalent defect. And that causes a lot of pain in your body.
Exactly. Back pain also, knee pain also, everything. I have a pelvic tilt.
Oh, so you have that tilt?
Yeah, I have, like, proper.
I think Maitri told us that she has the same thing, and there's a different way to squat if you have that tilt.
Yeah. So a lot of things were going on with my body. Now she finally diagnosed me. This word, it's a very, very, very huge word. But point being that my patella is gone.
Okay.
So she told me that she's going to have to fix it and everything.
Mm.
So she's like, give me 2 weeks of her life. I was like, okay. So those 2 weeks technically start today after this, because I had my exams going on.
Right.
Problem is that I'm not actually allowed to sit a lot.
You can jump.
So I had exams going on. She's like, I can't fix your knees. So basically, you know, when your knees are gone, I didn't know this, it is because of your glutes.
they are weaker.
And Shivangi told me the same thing. Shivangi squats like,
it's always a muscular imbalance. It's always like if your triceps hurt, maybe you aren't training your shoulders right, or maybe something or the other is weak and not balancing the whole
body. But you have to imagine how offensive it was for me and how offensive it might have been for Shivangi, because if you've seen her squat, and I used to squat like 45 too, and I was like, what? My glutes are weak. What are you talking about? And she's like, this is where all you gym people are wrong. You all don't know what core strength is. You all don't know what glute strength is. You just go and you lift. That's all that you do. And she gave me so much knowledge about my core, by the way. Such a horrible core. She's like, if you don't fix your core, all your joints are going to
move.
It's all related, you know, so it's like...
Especially if you're lifting. If you if you have a normal lifestyle, you just take a walk and all, that core will support even walk and all. But you were lifting heavy stuff, iron and all, then you need to have a balanced body. You can't mess it up.
So yeah, getting it fixed now.
Ah, pretty cool. Do you want to ask anything?
I thought you could end it. Put you on the spot.
That's very weird, man. I think you have so much to tell. I mean, I'm
I do, but now I don't know. Even I'm on the spot. What?
Ab tak main kya kar rahi thi? But anyway, tell me about your writing. You also like to write,
So you private too.
No, I'm not telling you to recite anything. Just just tell me about the.
Because what happens is that there are so many times when I'm sitting with people, and honestly, I have not found one human being in my entire life who kind of goes along with the same wavelength, if you know what I mean. See,
when it comes to writing.
No, I'll tell you.
Or expressing.
Expressing. Huh. Writing is because of that. Because of the fact that I have never been able to kind of have a conversation with someone who doesn't talk about my life, his life, or anything but just life. And that has never happened with me, but I have so many thoughts. You know, there are times when I've expressed those thoughts and everything, and I felt like nobody really absorbed it. And honestly, I've not said it to for people to absorb it, but you know, when...
Maybe you did.
To a couple of people, yes. To someone I love, maybe. like your boyfriend or your partner. Or, you know.
It has to be pure. If you think that someone didn't react to it, then you didn't do it for yourself completely.
True.
When you absolutely do it for yourself, you'll get to know. It won't trouble you.
No, it won't trouble me. Only that's what I'm telling you. Writing is that to me. Right. I do it for myself, no?
Right.
Because then I don't... There's no expectation ki nahi koi sunega, koi nahi sunega. It's just putting it on paper. And then I read it, you know. I go back and I read it and I try to... It takes me to bad places too. It's like...
It's supposed to do that. If it does that, it's good.
It's really awesome. So I actually did this thing. I don't think I've told you. I did start a writing page too.
Okay, nice.
It's not like I haven't... only very few selected people know about it. But I started... But instantly, you know, instantly, like I posted like 6-7 posts, I think it has. And when I started doing it, I just felt really bad about giving it away to the world for some reason. I felt like, this is mine. And I stopped posting. I never promoted that account, never tried to, you know, sort of keep an engagement or everything. Because that is not Instagrammable to me. I can't give it away, you know. So, yeah, like I write because of the fact. And also the other things that I write, the things that I do put up, like, you know, the caption of transformation. Those things, honestly, like, I feel like I still hold back. There is so much, you know, to kind of talk about. Like, you can see right now, my mind is going everywhere. I have, like, just constantly processing things and everything.
That's how we want people to be over here. Yeah. Otherwise, it's very stupid. Okay, I want to talk about this.
I'm going to screw up so many times. I know it. I might have already screwed up a lot. But that's okay. So, yeah, that kind of writing is super important to me. That's why I want to take up journalism. Because and it's something that I never thought about, I'll be honest. Journalism is not something that was in my head. Journalism is something that was put in my head by my fan.
Okay.
There's so many people who told me, you know, that listen,
you should
do this professionally. You should see the people who tell me you should write a book. I can't write a book. I know it. Because I can't imagine myself constantly, like, sitting in front of, you know, a typewriter or a computer or whatever and doing this for a living. It's just really as simple as that. I'm not saying that if I may not do it ever. I mean, you never know where life takes you, right? So maybe I'll do it. But it's not like I can decide that I'm an author.
You'll never know when the author you know, dude, wakes up inside.
Yeah, it will happen. I might go through an experience that might make me feel like, shit, this has to be told to the world, and I will be like, okay.
Not even for that. You never think like that. Sometimes you can maybe. I don't know what that feels like, but sometimes you will feel like, okay, I need to write this. That comes secondary, that okay, you know, I will publish or not. But
there will come
a time when you're like, fuck it, you'll end up writing this much, and then you're like, okay, let's publish it.
There's something similar that happened to me. There was this one time when I was so heartbroken, Abhimanyu. Oh my god, it has to be the most heartbreaking moment of my life, and I wrote this thing.
Okay.
And I couldn't stop writing. It's just like tuck, tuck, tuck. I'm going. It just became so big. And I still have it with me. Whenever I read it, it scares me.
Right.
You know, like the amount of, you know, how dark all of a sudden I became. I was like, what the fuck? I'm talking about death and shit like that. What is that? It's crazy. But, you know, it took me somewhere. So I know I have experienced one moment in my life where I felt like writing did something to me.
Right.
You know, so that has happened. I don't wish for it to happen again. Maybe that's my point. You know, like I don't want to go back to being anybody other than right now. You know, I'm like being.
It's a very toxic
positive
zone. I agree.
Exactly.
It is.
Exactly. So now I want to do it professionally. Like for, you know, I want to be able to write for a newspaper someday. Mm. I want to do crime someday. I love that shit.
Right.
So yeah, there are things like that I want to do because I know that I can do it. Mm. It's not. It was never a passion. I have to be honest. Passion is very much restricted to the things that I don't put out for the world, you know, the things that I write over there. But over here, it is like, aur kuch tumhe samajh mein nahi aa raha, mujhe acting nahi karni hai. Food blogging cannot be a profession, but this is something that I feel like I can monetize my life from. So yeah, that's where it's going now.
You can always become an influencer.
I see you going that road in a way. Yeah, let's hope. No, like a gen, since I said that you are a genuine one, because you don't put bullshit out there and you don't preach. So maybe let's
actually
hope.
You know, one thing that I did want to say, that person who commented on your picture saying that you just have a 10s whatever and you take pictures, I do feel like there are a lot of people like that out there too. Like, I'm not saying you're one of them, but I'm saying there are people who classify themselves as bloggers only because they have good phones with good cameras.
Yeah.
How far will they go?
But that's what my point is, that, you know, I think people eventually see through that. I really believe in that. Like, Abhimanyu texting a message, sending me a message and not sending someone like that a message. Mm-hmm. It's itself like a very...
To be honest, we could have given many people a shot, but we looked at the profile. I shared your profile with her.
Mm.
And that was this instant thing, let's call her.
Yeah.
I don't know why, but it connected somehow.
That's
makes sense.
You know, eventually I really think people go to a word. Dude, there's so many accounts. Like, right now when I'm talking, like, the usernames are like popping up in my head.
Landing college students who have no work.
And not taking their hard work away from them. They are doing a fine job.
You know what? Sometimes I actually question whether they have clicked that photo themselves actually or not.
Who cares? They're sharing, man. They've become a medium, a platform. Who cares?
But it's called plagiarism.
I thought you were saying.
Okay.
Someone else's picture, then,
yeah.
Yeah, of
like, they may not even.
It's a theft. It's a theft,
right?
It's a theft.
But then the world is such a big place. How will you know if somebody's reproduced your artwork somewhere else? How will you know?
No, this happened with me 3 days back, and I saw, I told my entire family, like, listen, report this account. And they're posting and they're even tagging me.
Listen, don't do that. That's a good thing. That's what I've learned. If people have started taking your work, that's a good thing. Let them.
And they're taking my photo.
You can't
photo of my face.
Yes.
Yeah.
You can't
that's extreme.
That.
I thought your food
no,
was
no,
just...
no, that is okay.
There was somebody else also, so she's like a model. She's like a proper model.
Yeah.
She shoots and everything. So some bloody corner of this country, they started an account. First initial pictures, there was no picture of the person. It was like face hidden, some weird thing. Then suddenly there were like so many pictures, all of this particular model. She's basically impersonating someone else with a different name. So I'm like, what are you doing?
Yeah.
Why are you doing this? Stop being
the way girls and guys are.
No, but this wasn't with me. No, it wasn't. Somebody wasn't taking my pictures for like pretending to be me or whatever. They just had an account where they were posting pictures of good looking girls.
Okay.
Wow. And they just
I like the fact that she just said that they were taking pictures of good looking girls. Okay, go on.
Shit, I do have emotional.
No, it's perfect.
So I'm calling them good looking, I'm not calling myself.
Yeah.
They were really good looking. So yeah. So they were doing that, and I a very interesting thing happened. So I messaged them, okay? I was like, listen, I'd like you to take my photo down. And it was 9 out of 10 times it has worked.
Right.
This person actually responded telling me, I don't remember the exact words, but this is something on the lines of, why would you want that? I thought girls, good, hot girls like you, not good looking, hot, some sleazy word. Hot girls like you would want to get the attention or something like that. He said models like you. Okay, no, maybe it's a hot girl. He said models like you would. That is because I remember my reply to it. I was like, first of all, it's really, really bad that you're stereotyping models.
Yeah.
Bichari. Matlab, unka matlab wo insaan hi hote kya. And B, second, you have taken it without my permission. C, you're not taking it down. Even when I'm asking you to take it down, I'm hoping you're applying this shit.
Yeah.
And then I took a screenshot of that and I
really
did it's kind of degrading, yeah.
That's so bad, yeah. Freaking models.
Anyway, Naman, I had a fun time. It was good talking to you.
Okay, that's over just like that.
Yeah, yeah. It's always never over and it's always over. That's the thing.
So
something that you want to share before we actually we'll edit this part and we'll put that part. It doesn't matter where.
No, I know. I've realized that, you know, like I say, wake up se wo chal raha tha. I'm like, achha, this is going to be like properly edited. Anything that I would like to share about this?
Yes, absolutely.
I will tell you that I've never had the chance, even on a date.
Uh-huh.
You know, which is really, really like such an insult to all the guys that I went out with, to be able to put myself, you know, so much of myself in one go.
Okay.
Ever. Like so much, like in the last 1 hour or whatever.
Oh, the way you've done over here.
Yeah.
Touched.
You know, really, because it's crazy. It takes at least, you know how you make new friends and then they start to come to, like, get to know you and stuff like that. That happens and it's a process that, you know, it's 1 month, 2 months,
yeah, it takes
depending
time, it takes
on
time,
how
yeah.
much you meet and how much you talk and all of that. It's, I have never been able to, and I'm not saying talking.
Right.
Talking you can do.
Yeah.
You know, like, but
expressing,
to be, yeah. And to be able to get that from you and to be able to give it to you, I think it's really, really cool.
Oh, thank you. I'm glad.
You're doing this, actually. Wow. Like, it's such a good thing for you to be able to do it, you know, to be able to sort of make something really significant out of it.
Let's hope so. But I'm glad that we made you feel that way, that comfortable that you were. Thank you.
Thank you so much, man.